Now, let's look at how to find out the domain of a function. The example here is that the function f of x is given 1 over x minus 3 times radical x plus 1. We know this expression requires denominators cannot be zero. Okay, we know if denominator were zero, then the function would not be defined. Okay, then here x minus 3 cannot be zero. If x minus 3 is zero, then zero times whatever here it is, you have a zero. So the whole denominator will be zero, then the function will not be defined. Okay, so x minus 3 cannot be 0, then both sides add 3, cancel negative positive 3, you have a x on the left, 0 plus 3 on the right, so x cannot be positive 3. So if you plug in positive 3, you can see here clearly 3 minus 3 is 0. So x cannot be positive 3. Okay. Now in this radical sign, x plus 1 cannot be negative. Can it be 0? For sure not. So here x plus 1 has to be a positive number. Has to be a positive number. Okay, since x plus 1 is inside the radical sign, it also requires x plus 1 has to be positive. Now, x plus 1 is greater than 0, minus 1 on both sides, cancel positive negative 1, x must be greater than negative 1. Because 0 plus negative 1 is negative 1. So combine those two conditions together. From negative 1, negative 1 is not included. Okay, you plug in negative 1 here, negative 1 plus positive 1 is 0. Okay, so negative 1 is not included. Then this circle has to be empty circle. From this point to the right, it looks okay. But we required that x cannot be 3. So 3 has to be excluded. That means from negative 1 to positive infinity, we have to exclude this 3. So how to express the solution? You want to write in this way. From negative 1 to positive 3, 3 is not included, so you use round bracket. Okay? And then from positive 3 to the right-hand side. So here, union means both two ranges you want. You want those two. Okay? And from 3 to positive infinity. Again, here, infinity is not included, so you always use the round bracket for infinity. Okay. Okay, that will be the domain for this function. Remember, this is a very typical example. It has radical sign, it has a denominator, so denominator cannot be zero. Expression inside the radical sign has to be non-negative. In this case, it has to be positive because the denominator cannot be zero. And then solve those two separately, combined solution in this way. Okay, I will see you next time.